Welcome to New Orleans, and it's Bloody Mary, and this is the Bloody Mary Show. Happy Toussaint! That's All Saints Day, which is the eve of All Souls Day. So what do? You dance with the dead. In New Orleans, we celebrate it in many ways. We have to visit our family, of course, first. And then all different places all throughout town. Go to as many cemeteries as you can. Give offerings. Feed the dead. And wait for the priest to come and individually bless your tomb. Well, that's the way it used to be. Now there's more of a mass blessing. But you can, both the living and the dead, get a blessing in the cemeteries as you walk throughout. So some people have rituals at night. We even have parades. And of course, you best visit the tomb of Marie Laveau. Now, throughout the years, tourists have come up with some fake Marie Laveau tombs, and they're going to be shown in these videos. Some of them have been redone, so you might not recognize them, but it's where many tourists used to go. However, there is the one and only real Marie Laveau tomb, and that is the tomb of the widow Paris. There are many other voodoo practitioners in the cemeteries which will be given offerings. And it does not mean that it had anything to do per se with Marie Laveau. Some of her family and co-workers would also be here. This one has been redone. Many tombs have been redone since they redid Marie Laveau's tomb. But she had three of her own that she owned inside St. Louis one, but they weren't the ones that you thought. Anyway, her remains are one way to go visit her. You can't leave offerings there anymore, but people have started to bring offerings here to where I am transmitting this from, at her cottage at 1020 and 1022 St. Anne Street. This is the tomb. This is the tomb of Voodoo Queen Marie Laveau, the three-shell family tomb, which houses many of her children, and Christophe Glapion, her common-law husband. There are many others in this tomb. Almost 100! Yes, we could fit that many people in one tomb. We have a little idea, reuse here. Drop the bones down below and toss the coffins away. Put the bones back in and keep on going. Not all of these were family. Some of them were friends, and many, many were children. Marie Laveau was known to take care of the children, to take care of everyone. She gave them a place to rest, living or dead. There are several other tombs out here that she owned, and one had to do with enfants written right on it, or so we think. Marie Laveau was an incredible healer, a Florence Nightingale of sorts, and she worked with the midwives too. She was miraculous and still is. Voodoo Queen Marie Laveau was the number one visited tomb in the country prior to COVID. People made pilgrimages to her for her magic, her healings, and her wisdom. Marie, my starter candle. Welcome to the Bloody Mary Show. Happy All Saints Day. And as we say in New Orleans, Toussaint. I put three drops of holy water on the wall. Hi, guys. I am here in the old homestead of Voodoo Queen Marie Laveau. And hi, I am Bloody Mary in New Orleans. I've just come from the graveyards, and that's what we do today. You go to many, many, many graveyards. You visit your ancestors, your friends, and your family on the other side. You connect with those that built your town. That's my full-time job. I connect with those the architects, as I call them. And of course, Marie Laveau is a very important part of our history and mystery. I'm a priestess in the tradition of Marie Laveau, as well as Haitian Voodoo Mambo, as well as Yayana Kisi Malongo, as well as a few other titles that I have, including New Orleans Catholic. And believe me, Marie Laveau was definitely New Orleans Catholic, as was her mother and her grandmother and all those around her. Originally, we were a 100% Catholic town, and we, to you, may look like a southern city, but nope. Gateway to the Caribbean, connected to the Yucatan, connected all over the place, including Europe, we're a displaced European colony. And these things are reflective in our customs, in our food, and definitely in our mysticism. In fact, in voodoo, the intermediary spirits are known as the mysteries. These days, most people call them the low, but that's not what they were called yesteryear. So people have a tendency to say, oh, the New Orleans voodoo didn't know the low. Yes, they did. They knew them as spirits. They knew them as saints. They knew them as invisibles. They knew them as mysteries, many different names. There is one God in voodoo, Grand Met, Grandmaster, intermediary spirits, the ancestors, the nature spirits or elementals, if you will, for this is an animistic belief system and you, or we were all or are all together. Anyway, I started off with that because this is November 1st, All Saints Day, the Eve of All Souls, which is November 2nd, called by some people Day of the Dead. But all these holidays were very active in Latin Catholic areas, and that is what we are and were here historically in New Orleans, Latin Catholic. We fed the dead. We had picnics with them today and still do. A few families were left out there, but it was very quiet. And I'm going to show you what I filmed while I talk, okay? And all through the cemeteries, you could see that some people came and give offerings because it was a quiet day out there. And I got to spend time at Marie Laveau's tomb, which I haven't in a very long time, either filled with tourists or other problems. It's very hard to sit and be still, but I was able to do so today. Bringing those energies from there back to here and from here to there is part of the process of the connection. And from underneath the spirit of land, I'll bring it up so I upload it, if you want to use modern terms, and then download it to you through a variety of ways, through automatic writing, which I'm going to do some today, and through direct channeling, which I also think I'm going to do some today. And I might do a little bit of ghost box. I might also try a ghost box session. Again, I just came from 5 graveyards, but I came from St. Louis 1 and St. Louis 2, where Marie Laveau and much of her family is buried. And Marie Laveau in life spent time visiting people like herself in St. Louis 2. I'm also going to read some excerpts from my previous book about Marie Laveau, Hauntings, Horrors, and Dancing with the Dead. Her spirit permeates this town, and I will do a reading. Hey, this week, it's just me and the spirits. I've been so busy through Halloween. It was just hard to get anyone else to sit down and be my guest. So, of course, all of you, be my guest. And Yolali Mamzal Marie. So I'm going to start a little channel and I'm going to overlay this with scenes of the graveyard from today in New Orleans to you. So I just want to let you know that rocking and rocking chair is absolutely a way to help channel, to get you out of body. Dancing is a great way. I like being in water as well. All of those ways. And Marie Laveau spent a good deal of time in her rocker, and she wasn't just sitting there. Open the gates. Do any of the spirits here have anything to say? I would like to translate, transcribe. I am the voice, I am the storyteller, I am the griot. Tell me what you want them to know. Yolali Mamzel Marie, Marie Laveau. Marie Catherine, Catherine Grandmama, children with Marie's.
Which one would like to talk? Which one would like to be seen? What am I going to see and talk about today? I just came from the graveyards. One of the things that Marie Laveau was very proud of was that she had a shawl from the Emperor of China. Or so was the story. This is the shawl, one of the shawls of my great-great-grandmother who lived across the street right here. So I'm just going to throw that on my shoulders while I rock. And that's the first thing I saw. So the shawl, the Emperor of China, gifted her. People from all over the world sought counsel with Marie Laveau. She was an incredible healer. Marie Laveau was a great psychic. She was a politician, too, and she was a good Catholic and an incredible nurse. So throughout all the times, I'm seeing walking through the street, walking over bodies, trying to make it desperately to the next place, place after place, to soothe and to help those transition into the other side. Marie Laveau, what was a psychopomp? That is something that's not talked about so readily. This is what I'm being shown right now. Yolali Mamselle Marie, what would you like me to see? It's all the spirits raising from the bodies. Even while she was trying to heal them, she was doing both. She was soothing the skin, but lifting the spirit. She was balancing those two at the same time. Yes, I think she knew what she was doing. She might not see it from the perspective that I'm seeing it now, but she's dabbing the sweat and cooling the body and talking in hushed tones, very quietly. My rocking chair is making noise. The storytelling, when all else fails, tell them stories as they go on their way. It's like a dance as they slowly lift out of the body. But so many were doing it at the same time in times of plagues of New Orleans, and she would just go from one place to another. And unfortunately, even her heart couldn't stay smiling long as she birthed new babies, for so many stillborns were here. And the horrors on top of that is that she would be blamed for harming them when she was the one that helped them in and out at the same time and so many times. We had triple the infant mortality rate than the rest of the country in the 19th century when it was already horrendous everywhere. Plagues of yellow fever, cholera, dandy fever, many diseases that I don't even know the names of, neither did she. She would just comfort the flesh, comfort the spirit, help it move on its way. The strength that this woman had is not something that she could see. She only felt the fatigue. But the stamina was incredible. She kept going and going and going. The nursing was hard. Nursing was part of what she did. And she had such incredible healing powers that so many more people made it than should have. And I don't even know if she knows that. Or knew that at the time. She knows it now, for I'm being shown these scenes from her eyes or from her guide's eyes to my guide's eyes. I'm seeing the yellow fever wards and the sickness that was everywhere. The triumph of the living babies made her smile. She loved children. She buried children in many tombs, in her own tomb, in other tombs that she acquired. She baptized them too. They had to be baptized in order to be buried, and this was a problem. So she made sure they were baptized. You can baptize. I can baptize. I do. She made sure they were, as a co-midwife and helper and healer there, she would be at their side working heavily. I think she's trying to make her way back here. There's hardly any rest, definitely no privacy. People were knocking at her door all through the night. But she was hospitable. She was quiet, yet hospitable. I'm seeing her make tea or tisanes at the time. Probably had special herbs and elixirs in them in order to help with the heal. She's literally giving me a cup of tea right now, which I am going to trust and I am going to drink. Many of us are warned not to drink or eat things on the other side when we're there. But in this particular case, I trust. I am seeing the caduceus, the medical symbol. This is a healing tea. This is a healing tea, so I shall be healed. I shall take the healing, and I thank you, the spirit world. There's a slight part that still just like wants to get up and dance. Marie Laveau was known as a great dancer. I don't know when she had time. Maybe she walked across the way to Congo Square. But she visited the dead a lot. She spent a lot of time in the graveyards talking to the spirits, the ancestors. They're still with you and they're still in this house. Are there others here that would like to come near that have something to say? Are the children around? You can play with the dolls. I have extra dolls here today, left from Halloween. It is All Saints Day. It is a day that those that died in the faith can be raised again. And I just got a blessing over at St. Louis Cemetery number 2 by the priest who goes around and still blesses the tombs, just like they did hundreds of years ago at Toussaint. But then everyone was out decorating the tombs, wearing their first outfit of winter, and that is perfect timing for right now. It's cold. You decorate the tombs, the orphans would be let out so they could collect alms. And it was a time of revelry as well as sadness. As you waited through the night, this was a time of revelry as well as sadness. You waited through the night, burnt candles through the night, waiting for the priest to come bless your tomb. Is there something you want to say? Now I'm going to direct channel. Yo, child, there's so many things that we'd be here all night. We're just happy that you're here. We're happy we have some way to talk again. There's a lot to say, but no one listens. They chatter out there. They chatter out there about so many things, but nothing of what was going on in the day. This was a hard life, but I had it better than most. I had a house, I had a family. Most of them alive, or some of them alive. We had food on the table. We had money. We had God. God was important. Spirit was important. And we had the old ways. We had those spirits with us too. We heard some of the stories about how people were treated in other areas and know it was better here. But even just a little bit out of town, people were not so good. We try to help if we could, but right now I was focusing on the women. The women, all women, had problems. And it was our job to meet together and to connect with a stronger spirit in order to survive and to make our children survive. These were the most important things. Not all the nonsense that people want to talk about. This is real, everyday work. We weren't afraid to work. We weren't afraid to get our hands dirty. In fact, I work nonstop. I go work down at the river and work over the market over here and then work healing at home and teaching my own kids. I didn't have much of a personal life. But managed to have myself some children and they went on to make strong names for themselves and it's all of us together. And some of them didn't live on or carry on the ways, and we reached out and we found others. Found others that were nearby that would listen, that could listen, that would stop to tell the ways. I'm being shown a chicken. plucking a chicken. Using the feathers on the side, keeping the feathers. This is cooking a meal. This is not a spell, but you could use those feet and you use those feathers and you make that sacred and you bless that chicken before you cook it and after you cook it and then after you share what's left over. So there's everything. A little bit goes to spirit, right? You need spirit. I guess that was dinner time in the middle of all this, and food was important then and still important to the spirits. I just gave a plate of catfish and fries. You know, I hope that triggered a memory, because early 20th century, where there's some of the voodoo meetings and voodoo rehearsals like Marie Laveau would have here in the 19th century, had to get licenses and had to hide, and they'd hide under fish fry. So I brought a fish fry so they could remember that. But now I'm being shown a chicken. I don't know how to pluck a chicken very well. But I did fry a catfish. Breaking bread, sharing a meal, using all the parts of the animals, making sure other people have food, not just yourself. Feed them all. These are important things to be beneficent to others. And we would go now by the bayou. This is where I learned. This is where I go. That swamp magic is part of it all. I just go sit down at the edge and put my feet in the mud, deep down into that clay, into the mud. Hum me a song. And I start seeing them swimming versus the little snakes that come in near, but I don't care. And then I see the eyes and the bubbles as Le Grand Crocodile makes his way to me, and I call Yolali Le Grand. Some be Yolali Le Grand Crocodile. I sit at the edge of the bayou and wait. I don't move my ankles. They're set down in the clay. And I pull up that power. I pull up that knowledge. I upload it all through me, all the way up and back around again. And take a ride on the back of that crocodile and go to the other side. Now I see many other people walking around by you where I am. I see the movement of snake and the light of the eyes of the alligator all around as they come to impart their wisdom. Yo la li la grand crocodile, yo la li la grand song. Connected with the ancestors and the realm of the dead and the knowledge. I have a very handsome standing up snake right now with a top hat. I usually see this on the gator, but the snake is coming to show, yes, he too is dapper. Dapper and calling you forth. Not trickstery, not evil, not the dark one. But just the knowledge that has been here since ancient times. I say my prayers, I open the way and sing my song. I stand up, take a handful of that clay, mold it as I bow out backwards and walk away. Please tell me more in dreams and show me the way. Let me automatic write all of this and more as of today. Aye, Bobo. This place trances me out way too much, to the point that sometimes I'll trance and just want to go to sleep. I just wanted all of you to commemorate All Saints Day, to remember your ancestors today and tomorrow, most of the month, but especially at the beginning. So it's Halloween, All Saints, All Souls. We have a ritual tonight and a parade tomorrow night and the ancestors every day. So I am going to read you from my book and show you some of the footsteps that I took today. Yola li Mamzelle Marie, I've come right from her grave to you. Amen.
Voodoo yet rules faithful disciples of dead sorceress Marie Laveau. Queen of the Voodoos in the 19th century New Orleans rites, died many years ago, but her ghost still lingers in the city and inspires a number of her faithful followers to make midnight pilgrimages to her tomb. Her gray ghost haunts the city which she imperiously ruled in the voodoo rites. Times-Picayune, New Orleans, March 7th, 1937. the legacy. Now to New Orleans' number one called upon spirit, who flows through most all racial and religious barriers and also has the most visited tomb in the country. I present the internationally renowned Marie Laveau, the Voodoo Queen. Her tomb, her life, and her afterlife haunt New Orleans throughout the ages in whispers and hushed tones, in times of trouble and through troubadours by broad daylight, telling her tales. For 80 years on this earth, Marie Laveau's spirit raged on in the insurmountable odds of the real world of 19th century New Orleans, and 56 years later, after her death, she was still consulted and making headlines. Now, 135 years after her death, she has more faithful disciples than ever. Her spirit is venerated and will continue to permeate New Orleans as well as the controversies of her life. Nevertheless, 222 years ago or so, a star was born. Some say legends are born, others say they are made, but in many ways they are forged, tempered, heated, cooled, and transformed. This process continues in afterlife. For in spirit, she is as strong as the iron her forebears forged in their ancient cauldron of life, and as in the sacred smithing of ancient Africans. Rituals surrounded the necessary process, and offerings and sacrifices made along the way. In the special case of Marie's legendary growth, both before and after her physical death, she has reached beyond the limits of just New Orleans. There are many exalted ancestors, voodoo spirits in villages and tribes, whose spirits are elevated as leaders and protectors of the bloodline served by their specific family voodoo tradition, who are unknown outside of their particular region. But Marie Laveau has surpassed this locals-only realm. She is known the world over and is called upon as the Popess of Voodoo. She's an active spirit, and her ghost permeates New Orleans in legend and lore, music and magic, vision and apparition. This fact, along with her historic personage, has left an indelible imprint upon New Orleans. Add in the sheer number of people who visit her tomb and evoke her spirit, willingly or not, and she, in my estimation, is the number one spirit called upon in North America outside of the confines of the church and her canonized saints and intermediaries, angels, and other traditions. But just who is Marie Laveau? We have many ways to understand her through legend, history, and supernatural knowing. And is she really a ghost? Well, yes, by some definitions. But accurately, she is more. She is a true mystery, a voodoo, a spirit, Loa, ascended master, sinner, and saint. All of this and more describes this free woman of color who was born in 1801 in New Orleans and died in 1881. We're going to explore directly through channeling as well as research, and we ask you to follow along. This was an excerpt from Hauntings, Horrors, and Dancing with the Dead by me, Voodoo Queen Bloody Mary.
Hello, happy All Saints Day. Do you have something to say? It's Bloody Mary. Hello. How many spirits do we have with us today? Four. That was quick. Happy All Saints Day, Toussaint. Kekila. Kekila. Who is there? What is your name? Do you have a message from the other side? Hello? This is the old school problem. Smack, smack. Hey, batteries. Hey, spirits. Please talk.
There's a prayer of the New Orleans Saints.
New Orleans Saints. Marie Laveau, are you there? Can you hear us? Catherine, are you there?
Catherine.
Someone's at the door. So you sit here and talk to our people while I go to the door.
There. Power in DC and a
Okay.
Someone was at the door. Any message?
Giants, it's, you know, legendary. Yes.
Anybody got something to say? Knock, knock. Hello, it's Mother Mary. What do this? Happy All Saints Day. Is there a particular spirit, especially Marie, that has something to say?
Now, there were cranes in the sky everywhere. When you look at like a day.
May I have a message? You have one thing that you'd like to say on this All Saints Day.
Father of the Saints.
Hello, Marie. Do you have something to say? Spirits. Close away.
I decided to close the way, but I forgot to turn off the camera.
Okay,
and for a good 5 minutes, I was messing around with a phone call. I hung it up, and after that, you can hear background noise. It seemed that the spirits used that channel to continue to talk for later. We hear them whispering at 37 minutes, I believe it is. You can hear murmurings the whole time, but they're too faded. So I've condensed it for you. Thank you.
Anna, let's call for a message on All Saints Day. What do you have to say?
This is Bloody Mary. Thanks for joining us today, All Saints Day. Remember your ancestors, toast to the ghost, if you will, for we are not alone. I'm an advocate for spirit rights, and your ancestors do watch over you, including those not yet born. Happy All Saints, All Souls, and Day of the Dead, and the whole month of November to the ancestors. Amen. Ashe. Aye, Bobo.